second page. And now to our other big story tonight, a major development in the officer-involved shooting death of an Iraq War veteran.
Today, a judge ruled it was unconstitutional when Officer Brett Lampiris-Tremba killed Kenneth Ellis. Action 7 reporter Ana Velasquez has been following the story. She joins us live with details.
Well, Doug and Shelling, I'm here at the 7-Eleven at Eubank and Constitution, and this is where the detective shot and killed Kenneth Ellis in 2010. That's why the 7-Eleven has this white cross here, because this is where he was killed. Now, from the start, the Ellis family has said that Kenneth Ellis never posed a threat, and he never posed a threat to the officers or to the community, and that's what the judge ruled today. Now, the incident happened in 2010. As I said, Kenneth Ellis held a gun to his own head. The city argued that because Ellis took a step forward while police held him at gunpoint, that he endangered the officers' lives. But the judge agreed with Ellis's attorney that Ellis never took the gun away from his head when the detective shot him in the neck. Ellis's sister says this ruling proves that APD needs to change.
It shows that you can't have a badge and go around and shoot and kill people and get away with it. He is still employed. He still works for APD. But essentially, the judge ruled today that he acted unlawfully.
In 2010, the city ruled that the shooting was justified, and Lampiris-Tremba, as you heard, is still employed by the city. A statement from the city says that the detective and the city are disappointed in this judge's ruling, that they believe that this decision should have been presented to a jury. They couldn't comment any further because next up is a trial in March where it will determine, a jury should determine, if the city was negligent in hiring this detective, given his background. Reporting live from Northeast Albuquerque, I'm Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7.